Launcher 1, a rocket that's a little bit different from the norm because it's launched from an aircraft. In this video, we will talk about the design of Launcher 1, why they chose to drop it from an airplane, and how it will compare to Rocket Lab's Electron vehicle. So let's talk about that. On January 17th of 2021, the company Virgin Orbit successfully launched Launcher 1 into orbit for the very first time. The day begins when the rocket itself is attached to the Boeing 747, named Cosmic Girl. Then afterwards, the plane takes the rocket up to an altitude of 35,000 feet above sea level, in which, when the conditions are right, the rocket is then dropped. 4 seconds after the rocket is dropped, the first stage ignites, starting to take the rocket up near space. Then, a few minutes later, when the first stage burns out, the second stage begins, taking the spacecraft into a parking orbit. Depending on where the mission is supposed to end up will impact what happens for the second stage, as that will lead to its final orbit. However, for this first mission, it is thought that they are aiming to achieve a 500 kilometer by 500 kilometer orbit, with a 60 degree inclination relative to the Earth. Now, the payload itself for this first mission was a NASA-funded project called ELANA, which stands for Educational Launch of Nanosatellites. Now, this is a way for NASA to incorporate universities to send their own CubeSats on board. Now, if you don't know what a CubeSat is, it's basically a very, very small satellite, only having dimensions of 10 centimeters by 10 centimeters by 10 centimeters for a 1U CubeSat. Now, for these payloads that were on board, NASA included 9 satellites or CubeSats that were provided by universities and one that was provided by a NASA center. Now, these satellites ranged in size from a little bit bigger than a baseball to about the size of a toaster. So these are really small. Why is Launcher 1 dropped from a plane? Now, at first it might seem a little bit crazy, but there are a few advantages to the design. Two major challenges that rockets run into is air drag, or atmospheric drag, and gravity. And by launching from a higher elevation, you can actually kind of deal with some of these problems. The further up you go, the lower atmospheric pressure there's going to be, and therefore the less drag you'll have to deal with. And you're still going to have gravity as a problem. However, if you're already higher up, you're kind of fixing the elevation issue. For example, it takes a Falcon 9 roughly 70 seconds to get to 35,000 feet above sea level, whereas Launcher 1 starts from that altitude because it's relying on the aircraft to get up there. So by launching from a higher elevation or off of an aircraft does provide many advantages. Some additional ones are the fact that it has this horizontal velocity that it's able to help it reach orbit. Additionally, it can launch theoretically from anywhere on Earth, as long as you're taking off from an airport that's allowing you to launch a rocket. So really, you have a lot of capabilities with an air-launched rocket. But what are some of the disadvantages? One of the disadvantages has to do with the structural integrity of the payload. Because when you design a spacecraft to go into a rocket, you have to be able to design it that it survives the rocket launch. All the vibrations or the shaking caused by the launch vehicle doesn't destroy any of the electronic components. Whereas you experience different types of forces when you're attached to a plane. Therefore, you have to design the payload a little bit differently, and it could cost overruns with the actual payload itself. Now, another challenge, which is usually considered a larger challenge, is the fact that there is an upper limit on how large you can design a launch vehicle that is going to be launched from an aircraft. The reason is because you can't really attach a Falcon 9 or a Starship underneath a Boeing. Now, Boeing aircraft have flown space shuttles before, but the space shuttle was never launched from one. Instead, you only have this upper limit that can only really work for small satellites. So realistically, you could never expect to see a Falcon 9 flying from an aircraft, unless we start to see a lot larger aircraft designed in the future. Another disadvantage is the fact that for a few seconds after the rocket is released from the aircraft, it's in free fall and you have very little control over it until the engines start. Therefore, if something went really wrong during those few seconds, that could be catastrophic to the mission. I should mention though that Launcher 1 is not the first air-launched rocket to reach orbit. It's been happening for 30 years now. The rocket Pegasus, which is owned by Northrop Grumman, first reached orbit in 1990. And the design is very different from Launcher 1, as it's a three-stage rocket that relies on solid rocket motors rather than liquid rocket engines. Which means that technically, Launcher 1 is the first air-launched rocket to reach orbit that is powered by liquid rocket engines. And Launcher 1 is also only two stages. Now, there isn't a lot of information available about this rocket, but we can talk about some of the specifications that are known. The entire rocket is around 21.3 meters long and has a maximum width of 1.5 meters. The first stage uses the Newton 3 rocket engine, and the second stage uses the Newton 4 engine, which are both developed by Virgin Orbit. Both of these engines use kerosene and oxygen as their rocket fuel. The Newton 3 rocket engine can produce upwards of 333 kilonewtons of thrust, whereas the Newton 4 rocket engine can produce upwards of 22 kilonewtons of thrust. The successful launch on January 17th was actually the second attempt for Launcher 1 to reach orbit. The first attempt was back in May of 2020. However, just a few moments after the first ignition sequence started, it ended up failing and therefore the mission wasn't able to reach orbit. In fact, it really wasn't able to reach much of anywhere. However, they were able to learn from that data and then provide this successful mission. But how does Launcher 1 compare to Rocket Lab's Electron rocket? And that's a very interesting point. Because Launcher 1, since it uses an air-launched concept, is actually able to send more mass up into space, upwards of 500 kilograms to a sun-synchronous orbit. However, Rocket Lab is slightly cheaper. Even though they can only launch upwards of 300 kilograms to low Earth orbit, they are only $7.5 million compared to Launcher 1's $12 billion. So ultimately, it depends on what payload you're looking for and if you want to choose Rocket Lab versus Launcher 1. But with this first successful mission for Virgin Orbit, they could potentially be launching four more missions in 2021 alone. So it'll be interesting to see how the small satellite launch vehicle providers grow over the coming years. But we'll just have to wait and see what happens. But with all that being said, if you enjoyed this video, please consider leaving a like and subscribing to this channel. But thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one.